From the JAMA Network, this is JAMA Clinical Reviews, interviews and ideas about innovations in medicine, science, and clinical practice. Here's your host.
Hello, I'm Dr. Kristin Walter, Senior Editor at JAMA. I'm joined today by Dr. Melissa Simon, who is a practicing physician in obstetrics and gynecology and a professor at Northwestern Medicine here in Chicago. We will be discussing the topic of over-the-counter oral contraceptive pills. Welcome, Dr. Simon.
Thank you so much for having me.
So it's well known that oral contraceptives are pills that are taken daily to prevent pregnancy. Can you discuss the two hormones that are included in most oral contraceptive pills?
Most oral contraceptive pills contain both estrogen and progestin. They are hormones that are naturally present in bodies of individuals who are capable of becoming pregnant. And what we're talking about today specifically is that progestin-only oral contraceptive pills can be used by individuals who may need to avoid one of those two hormones, such as estrogen.
And which individuals are advised to avoid estrogen-containing oral contraceptives?
Yeah, so those who smoke, cigarettes, tobacco products, those who are breastfeeding, those people who have heart disease or diabetes.
Nearly all oral contraceptives in the U.S. require a prescription. However, in July 2023, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved the first oral contraceptive pill that will be available without a prescription. Can you tell us about this over-the-counter pill and which hormone does it contain and how does it work?
Yes, this is a really exciting time in the history of the United States with respect to availability of contraceptive pills being over the counter. So this pill is a progestin-only pill. It's called Opill. It contains, like I said earlier, the progestin hormone, but no estrogen. And progestin-only pills prevent pregnancy by stopping sperm from entering into the uterus. They also may stop an egg from being released from the ovary in some individuals as well.
And are there some individuals who are recommended not to take progestin-only pills?
Progestin-only pills should not be used by people who are currently pregnant or who have breast cancer or a history of breast cancer. There also are some medications that may interact with a progestin-only birth control pill, such as anti-seizure medication, some antibiotics, and actually some over-the-counter supplements as well. So if somebody is taking one of those types of medications or supplements, they should consult with their clinicians before starting using the progestin-only pills, just to make sure there's no interactions between the drugs.
And can you describe how the progestin-only pills should be taken and what to do if a dose is skipped?
So it's really important that you take a progestin-only pill every day, about the same time every day, within about 3 hours. I recommend setting an alarm or associating taking the pill with a daily behavior, such as waking up in the morning or brushing your teeth at night, having those pills right there near the toothpaste and toothbrush. So if indeed somebody misses a dose by more than 3 hours or by a day, we recommend a backup birth control method, such as using condoms, and then take the missed dose as soon as you remember it.
And how effective are progestin-only pills in preventing pregnancy?
So progestin-only pills are highly effective in preventing pregnancy. There are some side effects, though, that I would like to talk about, and that includes having lighter or more frequent periods or some spotting between periods. Less commonly, some people who take progestin-only pills may feel a little nauseous. They may have a headache, but these are really rare side effects. For the most part, these pills are highly safe, highly effective, and have very few side effects.
And are the progestin-only pills helpful for treatment of other conditions such as endometriosis or acne?
No, they don't treat endometriosis or acne. Other types of pills, especially the ones that have estrogen in them, tend to be better for treating acne or even endometriosis. For any person who uses oral contraceptive pills, including progesterone-only pills like this Opill, we recommend condom use if you are trying to prevent sexually transmitted infections.
And what should people know about progestin-only pills and emergency contraception?
It's important if you need to use emergency contraception that you stop your Opill and take the emergency contraception and use backup for 5 days. Backup means condoms or abstain from sexual intercourse. Then you can proceed back on your Opill or your other birth control method.
The over-the-counter progestin-only oral contraceptive pill is supposed to be available in pharmacies in the U.S. in early 2024. However, there are a number of currently unanswered questions, including when exactly it will become available over-the-counter, how much it will cost, and whether insurance will cover it. Who do you think will be most likely to use these oral contraceptive over-the-counter pills, and how will the cost issue play a role in the accessibility of this medication?
Thank you for that question. It is so important right now that cost is carefully examined with respect to these Opills. Opills are going to improve access to contraception across the country, especially in states and areas where there may not be access to things like abortion care. And the accessibility of Opills is going to be critical for people of all income brackets, but especially for those who have the lowest resources with respect to access to healthcare, insurance coverage, money to afford any kind of medication, let alone an over-the-counter birth control pill. And so it's very critical for strategic consideration around the pricing of these pills, because they will be available and need to be used every single day and likely purchased a month's supply at a time. And therefore, with the cost burden of birth control pills, usually on the person who can get pregnant, it is crucial to consider the accumulated cost every month for a pack of birth control pills in order to prevent pregnancy. And if one puts this in context with how much having a baby or carrying a baby to term and then having that child and raising that child, birth control pills are a safe, effective, and cost-effective way of planning pregnancies for when the individuals who want to get pregnant can get pregnant.
Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us about this interesting and very important topic. I'm Dr. Kristin Walter, and I was just speaking with Dr. Melissa Simon from Northwestern Medicine. This episode was produced by Shelley Steffens at the JAMA Network. To follow this and other JAMA Network podcasts, please visit us online at jamanetworkaudio.com. Thanks for listening.